In this video, you will learn about k-means clustering algorithm in Python. K-means clustering is a method that aims to partition n observations into k cluster in which each observation belongs to the cluster with the nearest mean or centroid. We will work on mall customers dataset. A mall has its customers information such as customer number, gender, age, annual income, spending score. These are the information given here, and the spending score is between 1 and 100. If a customer is spending more, he or she is getting a high score, let's say 90 or 100, and if a customer is spending less, he or she is getting less score, let's say 1, 5, 10, etc. We will focus on these two columns, annual income and spending score. We can also consider these columns such as gender, age and customer. But we are more interested in understanding the relationship between the annual income and spending score. Let's go to the Jupyter Notebook and start our clustering algorithm. Let's import all the libraries. Import pandas as pd. Import numpy as np. Import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. We will use matplotlib to plot our data. Let's execute our code. We are going to read the data set. I'll make one variable data. From pandas, I will call the method read underscore CSV. And inside this, I will pass the CSV file name. The CSV file name is mall underscore customers dot CSV. Let's execute our code. Let's look at the top 5 rows of our data frame. We will say data dot head. These are the top 5 rows of a data frame, and we have columns such as customer ID, gender, age, annual income and spending score. We can also look at the bottom 5 rows of a data frame. We will write data dot tail, and we got the bottom 5 rows here, and the row numbers are 195, 196 and so on. We will select the column annual income and spending score, and the column numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. We want to select these two columns 3 and 4. I'll make one variable df. Then I will call the data frame data. I will use the method ILSC to select the column number 3 and 4. I'll make a list here. First I'll type colon. Colon means I want all the rows, comma. I'll make a list here, and I want to select these two columns. The column numbers are 3 and 4. In Python, column number starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'll write here 3, comma 4. Let's execute our code. Let's look at the top 5 rows of a data frame df, df.head. In the output, you can see we got two columns here, the annual income and spending score. Let's check the shape of our data frame df. I'll write df.shape. There are total 200 rows and two columns here. Let's visualize our data set. We will make a scatter plot, and we will plot these two variables, annual income and spending score. I will call plt.scatter, and inside this, our data frame df.iloc. I want to plot all the rows, and first I want to plot the column number 1, this column annual income, and the index number is 0. Then I have to plot the second column df.iloc, all the rows, and the index number is 1. I'll pass some more parameters. S stands for size, size equal to 10, and this is going to be the size of the dots that you will see on the scatter plot. The next parameter is color, and I will choose the color as red. Here you will see I am saying that first I want to plot this variable annual income, and the index is 0. Then I want to plot the variable spending score, and the index number is 1. Then the size of this scatterplot dots and the color is going to be red. Let's execute our code. In the output, you can see that we got a scatterplot of annual income and spending score. And if we look at the plot, we can see that there are total 5 clusters which we can make out of this 2 variables. This is going to be the cluster number 1, cluster number 2, cluster number 3, cluster number 4 and cluster number 5. Here this size, we can change the size. For example, I'll make it 50 and I'll change the color to black. You can choose anyone. I'll execute the code again. And now you can see that the size has increased and the color has also changed to black. Now next we will use the elbow method to determine the optimal number of clusters. Looking at the plot, we can see that there are 5 clusters, but we want to make sure that 5 clusters are good for this data set. So we will make an elbow plot, and this is used to determine the optimal number of clusters. From sklearn.cluster, we will import k-means because we are going to make the k-means algorithm here. We will calculate the within cluster sum of square and save in the variable wcss. I'll make one variable wcss, and in this we will save the within cluster sum of square, and this is going to be an empty list. Next, I'm going to run a for loop because I'm going to run this elbow method on 10 times. I want to iterate it 10 times to find the optimal number of clusters. So I will write a for loop here. For I in range 1 to 11. So it will not consider the last range, the last index 11. It will run from 1 to 10 only. Next, I will make one variable k-means. Then I will call our class k-means, and inside this I will pass some parameter. The first parameter is going to be n clusters, and n clusters mean how many number of clusters we want. We want 10 clusters and we are running a for loop. In I we will have 10 numbers here, so I will put I here, because when the loop will run, the initial value of I is going to be 1, then the next time it will be 2 and so on up to 10. The next parameter is going to be init, and this is going to be k means plus plus, and this is the initial centroid. When we make clusters, we have to first calculate the centroid, and from that we calculate the distance of each sample. So k means plus plus is going to calculate the centroid for us. The next parameter is maximum iters, and this is going to be 300. The default value is 300. If the algorithm does not converge before 300, so this parameter will stop the algorithm from further execution. And one more parameter we will pass here, n underscore init, and the value will be 10. This means that n underscore init means that the number of times k-means algorithm will run with different initial centroids. The default value is 10, so for 10 times this will run the algorithm with different centroid. Next, we will make the fit. We will call k-means.fit. We are going to fit it on our data frame df. Next, we will calculate the within cluster sum of score and then append in this list wcss. So I will call wcss.append, and to calculate the within cluster sum of square, we will call our object k-means, this k-means, and from this inertia underscore, the actual name of WCSS is inertia. We will calculate it and append it in WCSS. Next, we will plot plt and we will make the plot outside the for loop. PLT dot plot, and we will pass the range 1 to 11 because we want to plot all the optimal number of clusters here, and we will pass our list WCSS. Then I'll make the title PLT dot title. The title is going to be elbow method. Then we have X label, PLT dot X label. On X label we have number of clusters. Number of clusters is going to be between 1 and 10 because we are running the for loop 10 times. Then PLT dot Y label. On Y label we will have WCSS, within cluster sum of scores, and PLT dot show. Let's execute our code. In the output you can see that we got the plot of elbow method, and this is our X axis and this is our Y axis. Here we see that these are the optimal number of clusters given here because we have passed here in for loop 1 to 11, that is from 1 to 10. So we got here number of clusters 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and even here we can see that we got the elbow curve here at the cluster number 5. So we were right that the optimal number of cluster for this data frame is 5. You can see here this is the elbow curve, and here the number is 5, it is between 4 and 6. So the optimal number is lying between 4 and 6 and it is 5. So finally we are going to make the plot with 5 clusters. Let's fit the k-means cluster on our data set with number of clusters is equal to 5. Here I will call k-means is equal to k-means and number of clusters, this time because we have found that the optimal number of cluster is 5, so n cluster we will put it as 5 here. Init the centroid, we will say k-means which we used above, k-means plus plus. This will use to calculate the centroid, k-means plus plus. Next parameter is maximum iteration, which is 300, which we have seen above. And the last one is n underscore init. This is the default by 10. We have seen this above only. Next, I'll make one variable, labels. And this time I'm going to call the fit and predict, because fit and predict will give us cluster number of each observation. So I will say k-means dot fit underscore predict, and then I will pass our data frame df. Let's execute our code. Let's look at the number of unique values present in our variable labels. In labels we have stored the number of clusters. From numpy I will call the method unique, and inside this I will pass our labels, and these are the unique numbers 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. There are total 5 clusters. The cluster number 1 is cluster 0, cluster number 2 is cluster 1, cluster number 3 is cluster 2, cluster number 4 is number 3 here, and cluster number 5 is 4. So these are the 5 clusters here. We are going to plot these clusters and we will see how it looks. Let's visualize our clusters. We will plot our clusters. Our cluster number are from 0 to 4 here. So I'll write plt.scatter. Inside this I will call our data frame, and then I will call the labels. In labels we have stored these clusters 0 to 4. First we will print the cluster number 0, and then we want to print the column number 1. So the index of column number 1 is 0. Next we will print the labels again, cluster number 0, and next the column number 1, because the column number 2 here, the index of column number 2 is 1. Here the index of this column is 0 and the index of this column is 1. So here first we have passed the column number 1 and then the column number 2. Next we will pass one more parameter s that we have seen above. We will put it as 10, and then color. The color I am going to put is red. So this we have done for the cluster number 0 or cluster 1 here. We want to plot all the 5 clusters, so I will copy this and paste it 5 times, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And now I have to make some changes. Here instead of 0 I will put 1 because cluster number 1 here. Here also I will put as 1. Then we will print plot the cluster number 2, so I will write here 2. Cluster number 3, so I will write here 2. And here also 2. For cluster number 4, I will write 3, and here also 3. For cluster number 5, I will write 4, and here also 4. And you can see why I am writing 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, because the cluster number 1 is actually 0. So we are writing 0 for that. And I also have to change the color here. I cannot plot all the cluster with the same color, so I will type here blue, then green, then yellow, and then brown. So these are the different colors, and the spelling is missing, brown here. We will also plot these centroids for the cluster, which is stored as an attribute of the object k-means. So we will also plot the centroid. I will write plt.scatter from our object k-means.cluster_centers. I want all the rows, and for the column number 1 the index is 0. Similarly, I will write k-means.cluster_centers. I want all the rows and the column number 1 here, column number 2, and the index number is 1. The next parameter is size. Size is equal to 10, and then we have color. Color is equal to, let's say, pink. Then I'll make the title plt.title. The title is going to be cluster results. Then I will plot x label, plt.xlabel. On x label we have annual income. Then I'll write plt.ylabel. On ylabel we will have spending score. And then finally we will write plt.show. Let's execute our code, and we got an error here. We have to write ILOC, and here after df we have to write .ILOC everywhere. So I'll write that ILOC. Let's execute our code again. In the output you can see we got a nice cluster here, and we can see that there are 5 clusters, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. I can increase this cluster size. Instead of 10 I will put here 100, and here you can see we got the clusters here. And these big dots, you will see here I gave the color as pink here. Instead of pink I will type black. Yes, you can see the black dots here. These are the centroids of the cluster. This is the center point of this cluster, and this is the center point of this cluster, this is the center point of this cluster. All these black dots are the centroids, and to increase these plots, we can change the number here. You can change the number here. Instead of 10, you can put 50 here, or you can put any number of your choice. For example, I am writing 50 everywhere. The size will increase. Let's execute our code again, and here you can see that the cluster sizes increased, the dots are increased here. We got the 5 cluster here, and all the black points are the centroid of this cluster. And we can interpret the result as, when the annual income is high, you can see here this between 70 to 140. Most of the spending score is for this cluster, for this yellow cluster, is between 0 to 40 here, or 0 to 30 you can see. So when the annual income for the cluster yellow is between 70 to 140, the spending score is between 0 to 30. And when the annual income is between 0 to 40 for this brown cluster, the spending score is between 0 to 40 here. So you can interpret all this cluster like this. And this is how you can do the k-means clustering in scikit-learn, in sklearn. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.